An elderly man has died unable to escape a fire in his home in southern West Monroe. NBC 10's Brian Briggs talking to investigators and the man's family. What do we know about what happened, Brian?
Yeah, that's right, Gordon. We now know more information surrounding the house fire that has left Prentice Laurent dead. His heartbroken family tells us more about the man that they've lost.
Charred remains are all that is left of a home that caught fire Tuesday afternoon in southern West Monroe.
The Ouachita Parish Fire Department got a call to the 600 block of Howard Brown Road in West Monroe relative to a house fire. What, of course, firefighters unfortunately discovered was the body of the 92-year-old homeowner inside of the home after they were able to put the fire out.
The homeowner, identified by his family as 92-year-old Prentice Arendt, was found by investigators in his kitchen. Investigators were able to determine that the fire started in the living room. An official cause of the fire has not been released, but investigators believe that the fire was an accident. Arendt was in poor health and relied on family to take care of him. Witness statements reveal Arendt was home with his daughter leading up to the fire. She returned to her home to make dinner for him and the rest of their family when her husband noticed the smoke from down the street. They tried their best to get him out of the home, but it was too late. Now the family is devastated, but they're thankful for the life he provided them.
He was a great man. You know, I've been coming out here since I was young boy, you know, 8, 9 years old. I've been, you know, I fish now, and this pond back here is one of the first places I ever fished. I've taught myself how to fish. I was very thankful he let me come and fish in his pond being a kid, but, you know, he lived to be 92, and, you know, that's a really long life. It's unfortunate to go out the way he did, but he lived a great life.
Now, investigators have not determined a cause of the fire or Mr. Arendt's cause of death yet. For updates, you can head on over to myarklemist.com, and I'd also like to say thank you to the family for the venison as well. Live in the Media Control Center, Brian Briggs, NBC 10, your local news leader.